Communities on the mid-north coast have begun a gruelling clean-up operation. Floodwaters are starting to recede, leaving behind some heartbreaking damage.
As Taree's Manning River retreats, clean-up crews are moving in. In the city's streets and underground car parks, floodwaters are being pushed back.
Very dirty. Someone's got to do it.
Parts of the mid-north coast received their biggest June soaking in 40 years. 100 homes and businesses in Taree went under. It caused nearly $200,000 damage at Cliff Naylor's furniture store. Now he's fighting his insurance agency to cover it.
Insurance companies, I have a word for them, but I don't think I'm allowed to use it.
Across town, the Winter family lost everything.
They might dry out.
Yeah, they'll dry out.
Away on holidays, they'd stored all they owned in the back shed.
Half our stuff from the last 40 years of photos and that.
The rivers here are slowly going down, but as they do, this is what they leave behind. Thick layers of mud and silt are covering entire streets and businesses for kilometres along the waterfront.
And as the water level drops, there's a new danger. Overconfident drivers braving flooded roads. Last night, rescuers pulled a P-plater from his stranded car.
You see how deep the water was? A bit deeper than we thought.
Tens of thousands are still stranded in outlying areas. 14 shires have now been declared disaster zones. Financial assistance has been offered. Small comfort to those who have to pick up the pieces.
I pull my hair out. As you can see, I've done that, so I'm past that process. So now we're going to reload and get going.
In Taree, Andrew Denny, 10 News.